I like to express my gratitude to these three nice persons I can see in front of myself here, our icons of Egyptian dermatology, general, professor, just nice person, Dr. Magid El Sheikh, Dr. Ahmed Kadeh with his kind support, silent but always elegant, and Dr. Ahmed Nouh, for whom I really owe my life in Egypt for now. This is very nice to be in this platform. I watching the webinars and Luxor Derma generally, how it was erased in Egypt from beginning. So I'm very happy to stand here where was very famous people like Professor Maya Samahi, Dr. Amar Zaki, and the most adorable person I have met in Egypt, Professor Hassab El Nabi. This is our pathologist. And after all this nice thing, we can start our lecture. So my talk will be very simple, very little, but not less important than the another things here. It is about the sunscreens. All of us know that every single item, it can be treatment or can be poison. The problem is just dosage. So we hear before from Dr. Kadeh and Dr. Ahmed that we can treat some disease with phototherapy. But in the same time, if the this ultraviolet radiation, which is correspond to phototherapy we are using, will be Ziada, it will be so much, and it will be excess. So it will exaggerate the conditions and can make problem for our patients. So the first thing is definitions. What is the sunblock or sunscreen, or you can name it as you like. So it is any topical product which can be anything you can imagine. It is sticks, it is lotions, it is powders, everything possible. And it is supposed to protect from the sun ultraviolet radiation and its effects like photoaging, sunburns, discolorations and other things. Electromagnetic spectrum, this is our light spectrum. It have visible and invisible parts. So our main concern today is ultraviolet radiation, which is fallen into the blue part of the invisible light, violet, ultraviolet part, and have been divided to a few groups. First, it is vacuum ultraviolet, which exists only in the spacing. Then shortwave ultraviolet C, which is hermicidal and generally will kill anything live, but it's keep it away of us from our ozone layer of the earth. And the middle wave UVB and the long wave UVA. UVA is the longest wave of this radiation. He is penetrating the ears much more than any other. So you can see that most UV radiation is generated by the sun. About 10% of all lights reach the earth, 3 or 4% it is the ultraviolet radiation, and UVA is 95% of this 3 or 4%. The effects of anything can be either good or bad. So we have the good effects of the ultraviolet radiation and the bad. The good one is they are vitamin D production catalysator. So inside our skin, if we are not wearing all our clothes, that's why we have deficiency in Egypt so much. It will be catalyzate the production of vitamin C inside the skin, slow down keratinocyte differentiation, which we use in phototherapy of psoriasis and diseases like this, and disinfect surfaces. Ultraviolet radiation actually have this germicidal power. Negative things, it's what we all don't like, is photoaging. Sunburns, it's irritating but less problematic, because usually we just apply anything like Pantenol or something like this and it will be okay. Skin cancer or other diseases, and weakening the immune system. This ideas which was already here before. So you can see in this is hem, the latitude, the factors determining the local UV radiation level according to the part of Earth you are in. So for example, in Europe we use less filters for UV radiation, because it's okay, our sun is not so hot like in Egypt and things, but coming here, I was noticed even on myself, my skin tone become much more darker. And even I am trying to protect myself from the sun, but it doesn't help. The sun you have here is very, very powerful. So we need to try to protect our patient from its work. This hem you can make for yourself screenshot and try to see it later. This is about photoaging, the mechanism in details, but we will just forget about it and try to say simple words. The main problem of this photoaging, it is effect of oxygen species, reactive oxygen species or free radicals. So the beam of ultraviolet, taking off the weak electron, mainly this is a hydrogen, from the species and produce the special type of substances like superoxide, oxygens, and the hydrogen peroxide and things like this, which is easily attracted to another molecules in the body and can penetrate the homeostatic procedures or go to inflammatory cascade or anything. He can take electrons from any other molecule he meet on his place, for example proteins or lipids or any other molecule in the body. Skin discoloration. UV radiation induces immediate pigment darkening by chemical modification of melanin. And sometimes UV exposure will not show to you direct work after the exposure. You will see after a while, for example, you try to cover yourself, you don't go a lot outside, but you will, after a while, you will find that you are anyway darkening. So this is delayed UV radiation work. Now we can say that generally UVA and UVB get the similar effects on the skin. All of them make a problem with the DNA, they make damage with the cells, and they make photoagents, they make darkening of the skin. But scientifically we are agree for something. Let's say that UVA, as it's more penetrative, will be answer for the photoaging, and UVB, as it is lighter beam, it will be answer for us for the photoprotection of the of the skin color and make discoloration on the skin. So the systems, we have different type of sunscreens all over the world. We can say we have UVB and UVA, and UVB was discovered many time ago, so you can see this is old part. So we have sun protection factor, everybody saw on the bottles SPF. So what does it mean, SPF? SPF is sun protection factor, which is a number on the scale rating the degree of protection provided by sunscreen. So I have question to our nice professors, really, does sunscreens with the high SPF factor protect skin better than the one with the lower SPF? Okay, who can answer?
The difference between high numbers of sunscreens and a little bit low number is not big, as anybody can think or consider.
Yes,
What is important? The quantity you apply and the frequency. Frequency. Yes. How much you apply?
I agree. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
It's nice, but the answer is a little bit more tricky.
More tricky. Yes. We will the answer from
so
you.
So it is about the time. The problem is the SPF system for ultraviolet beam. It was tested on the people. So the testing is like this. You have the persons who go out without sunscreens, and you have another one who go out with the sunscreen. So the difference and the number corresponding on the bottles 20, 30, 15, 50, or a haga mean exactly the time. So how much time you can be protected, and after how much time you will get the same problem like the one who go out without sunscreen. So if you have SPF 15, basically it means you can be 15 minutes happy, and after 15 minutes you should reapply your thing.
Okay, I will discuss this point with our dear friends here. Okay, sunscreens. How to assure your patient that he put the optimum quantity, What do you tell your patient, Dr. Kadah? Let's start with
this. We use a fingertip unit.
Yes.
Very important.
Yes.
And I educate the patient how to do fingertip unit.
Mm-hmm.
Put about some like
fingertip unit. It's 0.5
gram.
Yes.
And to distribute in full face.
Yes.
And important, as you say, Dr. Nuh, now, in two frequencies, it's very important also. So,
yes.
The applied amount, applied quantity, yes, the type quantity, and also frequency.
Frequency.
Most of our patients are female.
Yes.
So
this is a problem.
This is a problem, yes. To deal with female
diabetes. Not dealing with the ears.
They always forget ears and around the eyes.
We are facing a lot of patients suffering from basal cell carcinoma in the
ears.
Wow,
you are right.
They are not applied sunscreen
in the ears.
And I think we have a big problem also. The formulation is very important. It's lotion, cream, rich, light. According per acne prone skin or not, oily face,
dry skin.
Also hands. Mm. Hands also is very
important. They put on their faces and forget their hands.
Yes, I see a lot of patients with the left hand and left half of face with dry.
Yes.
Yes. So it's very important and to educate the patient how to use sunscreen is very important.
Mm.
Yes.
Is it affecting the level of vitamin D absorption? As you know, most of us
have
very low level of vitamin D worldwide.
So does usage of sunscreens is accused?
Is it the cause?
Is accused in such matter of low vitamin D?
You cannot be accused. I think the problem is that people now don't go out to the sun. Aslan, yani, this is the problem. They are, because sunscreens, we will see later on the next slide. Anyway, even if you apply sunscreens, partially the photons will come, and the few photons will be enough to generate the catalyze the reaction. Mm. So it's okay, and it can be partially maybe. But our problem is we are not going out a lot.
I have my own answers. We are in Egypt. We have low vitamin D and not use sunscreen.
Yes, and you have low level of hemoglobin and all the time of white rice eating. Yes. So I think it is because the rice is absorbent. So I think your hemoglobin level is low because
rice
of
eating?
This. Rice consuming, the amount of rice you consume here in Normos, it is something.
Yeah. So
you eat rice with everything, with potato, with bread, with the kosher, with it's low level of the hemoglobin and things like this, and generally decrease the thing. Okay, so let's go to the other slide. And this is a basic guide to see. So the first one you can see that it is sun, and the sun, let's see, it's emerged 100 photons. So this is a beam he make. If you don't have sunscreen, all 100 photons will enter your skin. If you just have SPF 15, 93% will be erased. So you will have just 7% of photons enter the skin. The same thing with the SPF 30. It is just 97 and SPF 15 is 98. Above 15, it's already not important because it's already go to the part of the percentage and that's it. So the main concern here is the time. And we should educate our patients to apply because they come and say, okay, doctor, I apply sunscreen, but it doesn't help, okay? When you apply it last time, embarrach. Okay, embarrach the hegemus shahal shwayam. The UVR system. The UVR system have mark on the label like PPD or PA. PPD, it is persistent pigment darkening. So this is again about the testing on the people. The people go and test the UVA radiation on the skin, different time of applying. So the similar, it is contributes the same like this. So as more the factor, as more time you have to don't have the effects of the UV radiation on your skin. This is about UVA. There is another system of UVA, is UVA-PF. This is a UVA pro factor. It's similar to PPD, but the problem is it's tested not on people, it's tested on the artificial machine, so it's applied to the plastic, applied the level of the sun protection, sunscreen, and they say how much UVA beams will penetrate through this layer. So if you have the factor 2 to 4, it is preventive effect. If you have 16 plus, it's extremely effective. So it will not penetrate the layer of the product. It's not related to the time or to the your skin skin type. So ideally, if you want to have a good sunscreen, you're supposed to have SPF, and so it is the UVB, and UVA protection factor should be close. It mimic the effect that shades give you from the sun. So if you stay in shades and you don't have any sun direct to you, it will the same like if you have SPF factor and UVA in the high rates. In the some cases, like we have, if we have hyperpigmentation, better to look for a high UVA protection factor. Why? Because you see, you can hear some controversial in my words. I say, okay, the UVA is photoaging and UVB is the pigmentation. But the problem is the UVA will also make pigmentation and he penetrate deeper. So if you have already patient with melasma, don't let get it go deeper. You just use the photo protection with high UVA index. Okay, we have a question. Which sunscreen is better? Mm-hmm. And you remember this question because in end of this lecture we will find the answer. As you see on this down icon, you can see UVA, UVB, HEV, which is correspond to high energy visible spectrum. Mm-hmm. It is blue light between 400 and 450 nanometers, which is on all our concerns. He make this dark circles around eyes, which is our patient hates so much, and infrared radiation. So let's see which type of sunscreens we have. Basically, it's two types. It's either chemical or physical. Some people say it's the same. Some people say it's not the same. Okay, we can say they are work similarly. The same like UVA and UVB. They have similar effects, but some of them more depend on the chemical reaction and the other one on physical. So the chemical reaction, they absorb UV radiation and turning it during chemical reaction, turning it to the heat. So sometimes we can say that if you have patient with melasma, which can be affected by heat, we ask them not to go a lot to work in kitchen and things like this. Do you think that chemical sun protection will be bad for them, yani worse than physical protection, or you think it's okay? Any thoughts?
I think physical protection maybe better option, I think.
With no complication, yes. It's better with no
complications. With no complications?
Yes.
Okay, we can see. So we go the physical sunscreens, which will just reflect the light. So we have basically this thing. First ingredients, the chemical sunscreen have chemicals, which is organics. These organics can, they should penetrate the skin layers. They should go to the general processes which is occur there, so they will take time to work. This is first. Natural physical sunscreens, it is zinc oxide and titanium dioxide, and they are work immediately after application because all they need to do just to reflect the things. And suppose they don't produce the heat, they reflect the light from the skin, and that's it. And don't the important part, they don't have interactions with the skin layers or the skin cells or any processes coming there. So mechanism is absorbing or reflection. A suitable skin type. The skin type generally corresponds to the factor you want to get. So as darker your skin type, as less protection you need, because you already have your general natural protection for your melanocytes. The higher SPF factor in the chemical sunscreen is more this heavier molecules and is more risk factor of causing irritation. A lot of patients come and say, "Doctora, waki shams dat al tamiu hamsin gine ya lahwi wai kulu haka." وبعدين أنا بتاخد شوية في الوش وخلاص هو بيغرى ولا مش عارف أي. What is this? I need anything which is work better. Okay, for this purpose, what I tell my patients. I say to them, okay, you can try to use, because by far, this expensive, yes, they are expensive because they are not Egyptian, unfortunately, the gumruk here is very hard and you have a lot of taxes, so you should pay a lot of money for the foreign products, but What they are have, it's better sun protection factors. So I tell them, okay, you have very nice one on Egyptian pharmacy, named Zincosil, Arbagini, بس خلاص ما فيش حاجة. You can mix it. You mix this product with your product you have. First, you will less consume of your expensive product. Second, it is chemical, which is work at all. Second, you will dilute a little your product, which is can cause irritation, and it's supposed to be better. And generally, zinc oxide products soothing the skin. So it will get this tip for them, okay? And clogging of pores, this is very controversial part, so we will not put our attention to it. So the efficacy of sunscreen, we almost near to the end. The frequency of reapplication, sure, it is every 2 hours, it is the maximum possible time for any sunscreens, whatever how much it costs, 4 guineas or 400 or 4,000. Skin type. Skin type. So you can let yourself choose less sun protection factor if your skin is darker. Washing. If you wash your face, you should reapply. Halas, no way. Malush dawa. Sweating. If the oversweating is occurred, sunscreen should be reapplied. Amount of product applied to the skin. Most of the people who produce, companies who produce the sunscreen product say it is 2 milligrams per square centimeters. How much it's supposed to be? So what we say to our patient, this is 1/4 of tablespoon. Did you saw anybody to apply that much of sunscreen? But in Egypt is good, because you know all the time when I try to prescribe for them steroids ولا حاجة, I say okay, ما تعملش شغل مصري ما تحطش نص علبة من مرة عشان هو ما بيشتغلش أحسن لو بتاخد أكتر. Okay, so but they don't do this with sunscreens. I don't know why. And we come
because
here
because it's expensive.
But okay, if we give him Zincosil by Arbagini, it's not expensive. Yeah. She can let you herself to put Arba, but they don't do. And there is one more point about this also. Tinted sunscreens. This is solution for makeup users, or it is evil? What do you think? Is it any? Is it good product to be tinted? Or it's okay and?
Yes, sure.
Due to what?
I think it's no. Because you have to add more and more chemicals to make the color the patient asks for.
No, the production of color, it's very easy. No problem. It's just like a powder.
Quality of life, yeah.
But it is more bitter than the makeup.
Yes, okay, a lot of people come. Yes, I agree with Dr. Kadach, a little, but not all. 50-50.
I think I white skin, I prefer not to use tinted.
Tinted.
But for
a lot of patients come and say, okay, an eye cream myself, doctor, which company is better,
foundation.
Which one, which one I supposed to use? I say to them, okay, you can try to use your sunscreen. Sunscreen tinted, but the problem with the tinted sunscreen, you can see it in the very recent in literature, I get this idea command, okay, you can see now, the tinted sunscreens lead to a smaller amount of the product applied. This is a problem, so they will not apply enough quantity, because already tinted one have usually deeper color, so they will apply, it's like little normal makeup, and it will be not enough for the sufficient protection.
I'm talking about this point.
Yes, this is bad. Okay. So the photoprotective strategies, we need to block our UV photons, so we use it with the sunscreen, we need to repair DNA, we need to remove reactive oxygen species, we need anti-inflammation agents and the modulation. All this is done by flavonoids, and the chemical sunscreens help us to put it inside the formula. So our final question, we was asking, what is better, which sunscreen is better, chemical or physical, or which power better, 20 or 15? So when you sometimes ask the question, you see the question itself is wrong. So the right question, what is the best overall strategy to protect the skin? And the right answer is, it's important not to rely on sunscreen alone. No single method of sun protection can protect perfectly. So you need to seek for shadow, you need to use your clothes in the smart way. We have a lot of women in niqab, they come and say, okay, I'm wearing niqab, why I have melasma? Because niqab is black, mainly it's black. So the dark colors absorb the heat, make the problem for your face much more than if you don't wear it at all. And you can use a lot of other protection like hats and sunglasses and things like this. So as much you can protect yourself, is it better for you and your health. That's it for now. If you have any question.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, our dear guest today, Dr. Marina Juravlova, for this nice speech. And do you have any questions for Dr. Marina?
I have noticed and to hope.
Yes, okay.
Physical sunscreen, I think, and as you told, and our dear professors, it's more better, more safer, more good.
More cheap.
But yeah. I think if, and so more cheap, okay, for sure, yeah. I think if we have another formulations, maybe widely used and widely distributed, and I think it will be a revolution in sunscreen use.
Is it problem?
Yes.
Like Vaseline. Vaseline now present in the form of lotions, the form of gel.
Yes.
So I hope.
I
not
think
the problem of this one. Just one note, come on. This is the physical sunscreen is really better, but the problem is, for example, Zencosil. It is very big disperse of the particles.
Yes.
As less disperse the cream, is better it's work. So what you need in work in Egypt,
yes,
just make it less dispersed product,
yes,
and it will be
that's
just marvelous.
Yes.
In fact.
Yes. Yes, and more concern for the patient himself or herself that the cosmetic appearance of zinc oxide. When
yes,
they apply zinc oxide, the white color, they hate
yes,
this
they
color.
Hate
they hate.
But if it will be less dispersed, the color will
if
be disappeared.
You mean micronized version,
micronized version
of the molecule.
White color and the greasy effect. The
yes, maybe. Yes. If we have micronized formula of
it
zinc oxide, I think
it
will be very good choice as a physical sunscreen.
Yes.
Thank you, our dear guest, Dr. Marina, for the nice talk. And after very few minutes, we will have a dear guest also, Dr. Khadija Salami from Tunisia. And we will have a talk about PRP in her disorders. And we will enjoy this topic indeed, because it's a very important topic. It's daily practice. We want to know the pros and cons of such therapeutic model. Meet you after 2 minutes.